back to Three-Sided Box. This show is called, and rightly themed today, You Just Made the List! Listen in, man! Or you get it! And yes, we stole it. We don't give a shit. Do something about it. We're not making money off this anyway, so yeah, I can't really sue us for anything.
Vince can sue for zero.
Yeah, exactly. So, it's all in good fun. Today's theme with WrestleMania tomorrow, or at time of filming, or tonight when the video is out, because this will be out on the 2nd of April, yep. Hopefully. We are doing our top 10 wrestlers since last year's WrestleMania, who our favorite 10 wrestlers were since last year, basically, who we thought had the best years, who entertained us the best. And the format of the show is we each come up with our own top 10s. We're going to read 10 to 6, then 5 to 1 each, and then at the end we're going to come up with our own collective top 10 list. We did this, me and Franco did this with anime, so if you're an anime fan, go back onto the channel, check that video out, it's great. And yeah, so let's get started. Johnny, kick us off with your number 10.
My number 10, sorry, my voice, I don't know what's going on. My number 10 is actually, of late, Randy Orton. He's been impressing me a lot. That whole beef with Wyatt is really
burning down the
I found
not getting arrested for it.
I found it really cool that he didn't get escorted out by local law enforcement when that happened.
Yeah.
His blatant disrespect for fire safety gets me all hot and bothered.
Exactly.
And no, I really find he's. It's almost like his mind games are cool. Right? It's well done, well executed. It's more the creative team that's doing well, but I buy it when
I watch. He does a good job executing it.
And so because of that, he's my number 10.
I'm right into number nine.
I need to consult my list, which is now in digital format.
I'm the only guy who went old school and wrote it down.
Next is the list.
Next up is Seth Rollins, for obvious reasons. He's amazing. This year, the reason he slid down to number 9 for me is that he hasn't really been relevant as much. Now, lately, with the Triple H thing, okay, that could be cool and lead to more things.
Also because of his injuries.
Yeah, I know, so he got hurt and
But the babyface run, a lot of people aren't a huge fan of it.
Exactly. It's I get they want to play off the fact that he's rebuilding and redesigning the whole thing, but I think when he was a bad guy, it was fun.
You have to also consider the fact that they turned him baby because... Balor got injured.
Yeah, exactly. So, you know, you do reality, but it hurt him. That's what I'm saying. So he went down to number 9. Number 8, I got Charlotte, a diva. I think
women,
she's,
hey,
yeah,
oh.
Yeah, it's right. A women's division competitor.
She's 2017.
Sure, yeah. Although, didn't she retire the diva belt?
Yep, last year or something,
That's pretty cool. But she's, I find she's amazing.
She won the belt 5 times in a year, so...
Yeah, except, you know, this Dana Brooke thing kind of turns me off, so she's a little lower on the list. At her prime, though, she would have been a little higher.
Yeah.
I got Enzo and Cass as a tag team. I love these guys. Enzo can't fight very well, but Cass is okay.
Mm-hmm.
And on the mic, it's just, it's always funny.
Mm-hmm.
The puns these guys come up with are great. And, rounding in at number 6, I got the face that runs the place, John Cena. He's consistently good, fun to watch, good wrestler, great with the fans.
15 years consistently.
Yeah, exactly. So because of that, he's been in the mix still, you know.
Yeah.
And because of that, he finds himself in the middle of my list.
Yeah. And just a heads up before we shoot it off to a demo, no NXT stars.
No NXT
stars. We're keeping it to the main roster. Tag teams, we're going to consider them one, or factions if you consider the New Day. Women wrestlers are, of course, going to be involved, and obviously the men. So, next to you.
My number 10 is Charlotte. Ever since watching her match between her, Becky Lynch, and Sasha Banks, right?
Yeah.
It was a triple threat last year. I think we agreed it was the best match. Stole the show, and she always puts on a good match, and she's always entertaining. Even though sometimes we complain that when she's on the mic, she sounds a bit sarcastic more than anything, but she's always entertaining. She's part of the women's revolution.
Mm-hmm. She's a future Hall of Famer.
Yeah, for sure. Number 9, I have Sami Zayn. I always feel like a sense of pride because he's from Montreal.
That is true,
Every time he comes out, I always put myself in issues like, wow, this guy's from Montreal. I'm actually proud of it.
Well, lately he's been getting more of a push.
I think he deserves it, though. Like, he always does good with what he's given.
Yeah.
It's too bad he's not given more of a chance. Number 8.
It's because he's on Raw.
Yeah.
He should not do it. Shut up.
The show of
opportunity. Yeah, Team Red on this YouTube channel.
Yeah, he needs to be on Raw. It's the only thing that makes sense. He's got to be on the same roster with Owens because they're going to push him towards Owens.
Yeah.
Well, those two together are always hilarious to watch when they go head to head and clash heads. Number 8 had the Irish last kicker, Becky Lynch, part of that triple threat last year. It was tough to choose between her, Charlotte, and Sasha Banks, but I love Becky Lynch. There's just something about her. She's always entertaining. She can be funny, even like off camera. If you watch some of her videos off camera,
she's cute and quirky. Yeah. Like she's different. You know, she's not your typical girl, I guess.
Yeah.
Woman.
Number 7, I got a. I wouldn't call him a part. Well, he's kind of a part timer. Brock Lesnar. I was gonna say the one behind the one in 21-1, but I think I got Brock Lesnar.
Yeah, he's definitely a part timer. Yeah, 100%.
Yeah, this guy. Every time you come out, he always gets a huge pop.
He's becoming the new Undertaker for WWE.
Yeah, I think he is.
In the sense that he doesn't wrestle all the time, but when he does, it's big. Everybody's looking at it, and he's being built as this immortal.
I have something I'm gonna add to that. But I'm gonna do it later when
Except
I'm talking.
Goldberg is killing him, but now they're gonna make him kill.
Yeah.
You can always like feel that this guy can say zero words, just stand in the ring and you feel intimidated.
He actually hasn't said a word.
Like, just his presence. Yeah. Remember that time you just sat in a chair and like faced the camera and just wasn't saying anything.
Yeah.
He's just, I just love it. He's a beast. And number 6 is John. I have John Cena. I've been watching this guy since I was a little kid. Whether you're Let's Go Cena or Cena Sucks, you have to admit that this guy is... the face of the company, and he's done a lot for it.
Wasn't that Chad born at WrestleMania 31? Two years ago?
Yeah, it was,
I remember being at my friend's
house. That was the John Cena Sucks theme that started then.
Yes, that was a great moment.
Yeah, I don't know how that didn't start earlier, that was weird.
John Cena Sucks! Yeah. It's so good.
Yeah, I really don't know how it didn't start sooner. It's perfect. It's like the You Suck chant with Kurt Angle, it goes together perfectly.
Well, we both had number 6.
Alright, so my turn. 10, I'm going to give to the current WWE champ, Bray Wyatt, before WrestleMania, because who knows if he's going to lose it to Randy. You got to have the WWE champ on the list. I think that's a given. He's done a great job this year. I bought into finally the whole Wyatt thing. You know, it took me a while to buy into it. I finally am. I like what they're doing with Orton. Number 9, The New Day. They broke the record this year. That alone, it's more than enough to have them on the list. They were entertaining. They've been very out of the picture since they lost the belt.
Yeah.
But clearly, they're going to be the host of WrestleMania, and there's rumors that they might be going to SmackDown after Mania. So I think they were told probably, okay, we'll let you break the record, but then you're going to do nothing, and then after Mania, we'll give you something else to do. So that's my feeling behind it. And they're really entertaining. They're funny. They got a little bit stale now at the end, but I think that's just more because they've been out of it. More than because they've been in it too much.
I think Big E should pull a Seth Rollins on that team.
No. They need to
stick
together. Yeah.
Not yet, but
eventually.
Down the line.
Yeah, maybe.
But I find they can always keep it fresh where Enzo and Cass, that's always the same.
It's starting to get
lost. It gets stale.
Yeah. Number 8 is your number 6, John Cena. The reason why I have him low is because he held the belt only for 2 weeks. I wasn't a big fan of that. I wish they kept his 16th... title reign, record tying with Ric Flair. Yeah, they barely mentioned it. It was only for 2 weeks. I wish they didn't have him win the belt versus Styles. Let AJ beat him at the Rumble, then Styles lose it to Wyatt at the Elimination Chamber with Cena in that match. I think that would have been a better thing. I love Cena. I've always been a fan of his. I've seen this guy. I've been watching since 98. So I watched the Attitude Era, I saw the Ruthless Aggression, now I'm watching the PG. He's great. I don't get what people don't like about him. But whatever, he's my number 8. He could be hired next year, hopefully, if he does a little more full-time stuff, but rumor has it he won't. He's going to be doing a lot more movies, so we'll see. Number 7, I got the current SmackDown Women's Champion, Alexa Bliss. If you watch her in NXT, she didn't really wrestle great or much, and then they brought her up on the roster, took a big chance. They made her the only 2-time ever women's champion, SmackDown women's champion. So she's been really good for SmackDown. She's a beautiful woman. She's got a good ring sense and style. And I really appreciate what she's done. I'm very impressed with her. So good job with that, SmackDown. Number 6, I got somewhat new kid. He's been a year in now. The phenomenal one, AJ Styles. I remember watching this guy in TNA back, going back 10 years. Never once in my life did I ever think he'd be in WWE, let alone a WWE champion, which he was during the year. He was a great champion. He was the only reason why I really liked SmackDown for during the fall. So yeah, Wyatt, New Day, Cena, Bliss, Styles. That's my 10-6, and next we'll be doing our 5-1s.
All right, let me reconsult my list here. Yes,
5-1.
5-1's coming at you now. All right. At number 5, this is where I start putting the Beast. You had him in the bottom half, I got him in the top half, Brock Lesnar. Part-timer, but again, every time he wrestles, I mean, it's just so amazing to see the F5 hit. Everybody explodes.
I know.
He doesn't have to do anything. He's a Paul Heyman guy, which is always funny too, because Paul Heyman cuts amazing promos. So he comes out, pop for him, mm-hmm. and a pop for Lesnar. Fun to watch no matter where you put him. But it's obviously easy work for WWE Creative. It's just, let's put Lesnar with anybody
yeah.
big.
Okay. Yeah.
And that brings you to number 4, Goldberg. The most part-time possible.
Yeah.
But this year, seeing him come back, it was such a great return.
Mm-hmm.
The pop was through the roof. He's just as charismatic, just as cool as when he left. He hasn't aged at all, I find.
Just as dominant.
He's aged, but
yeah,
he looks great for his age.
He's in phenomenal shape, and they kept him in that same legendary Goldberg status.
Yeah.
Now, it looks like he's going to probably go away after WrestleMania. We don't
99%,
know. 99% chance, but still, he's my number 4 mm-hmm. of the year because he's super memorable.
Yeah.
And he's made this a good run.
Yeah.
Number 3, phenomenal one, AJ Styles. I think he's had the best year since WrestleMania of just about anybody.
Yeah, look, now going into Mania,
a little bit crappy.
They didn't really have anything for
yeah.
him. But yeah, up until
the year,
basically the Rumble,
yeah.
he's been
and when the brand split and all that happened, he was like really
yeah.
in it.
Yeah.
And he's still just really good on the mic. He's a great ring presence.
Yeah.
Great shape.
He's probably the best wrestler right now in the WWE.
Exactly. Overall, absolutely.
Yeah, I think so.
And I think this is only the beginning. He can,
oh yeah, 100%.
He's gonna go on a
yeah.
tear of,
yeah.
you know, he's got another 5 great years at
yeah.
least.
Easily, yeah.
Number 2, this is where it gets really Canadian. Kevin Owens. He is, since he came in, at first when he came in, I didn't like him too much. I thought, I knew where he was going, but I didn't think he was there.
Well, they kind of had him at the mid-level, and they really
yeah.
didn't do anything. They gave him the belts,
yeah.
but they didn't
and
have him do anything.
Nothing happened.
Yeah.
He had Intercontinental belt, but then where he really graduated was at the Royal Rumble against Dean Ambrose with that tables, ladders, and chairs match. Was it versus Dean Ambrose?
No, who did he face? It was
at the Royal Rumble?
Yeah.
This year's Rumble?
No, last year.
Last year's
where,
Rumble? I can't remember.
Where Triple H won. No, Triple H didn't win, but he came in last.
Yeah, he did win that year. That was for the belt. That's why he went to Mania
yes,
as the champ.
Yeah. But Kevin Owens.
Are you talking about the ladder match?
No, it was when he went through two tables. That was Dean Ambrose.
Oh, you're right. Yeah, that
yeah.
was. Yeah, you're
yeah.
right. You're right. You're right.
That was the.
Because I'm thinking about the chair random
oh,
thing
no,
he made
no, no.
this year
yeah,
at the
yeah,
Rumble
which was...
versus.
Now I'm blanking out.
Shit,
who's
the face? Oh, Reigns.
Yeah,
it was
yeah,
Reigns.
Yeah,
Reigns.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah,
of course.
Which was a good match.
Yeah,
yeah.
I don't know for once, but anyway.
Yeah, the guy who bought the Reigns shirt when we went.
Yeah.
I really like him. I don't get what you
I had high hopes for him at the time, and it didn't work out.
I didn't realize none of us, spoiler alert, have Reigns on our top 10 list.
True.
Yeah, he's...
But I'll give a good reason why, not just because everybody else doesn't like to like him. I'll give a legit reason.
Well, I think it's, you know, for me, he's off my list, and this is, let me get into number 1 first. The greatest guy on the roster is Chris Jericho, in my opinion.
Yeah.
Right now. He is putting over people. He's wrestling good matches. He's amazing on the mic. He has a great gimmick. He keeps adding to the gimmick, and he uses it perfectly.
He got a pen
yeah.
over with the crowd, where he just waits.
Yeah. And everybody's like, ah! Oh my God! Yeah. And then it's just so fun to watch every time he comes out. When he opens Raw, I'm happy, because I know the first half hour is going to be interesting. And I'm sold right away.
Yeah.
So Chris Jericho, number 1.
Yeah.
Yeah. I left Reigns off the list because I find, yeah, it's not fun to watch predictable stuff, but even if it's predictable, you can save it. Like, for example, Lesnar and Goldberg is probably a predictable match by most
yeah.
senses, but they're going to make it interesting by being themselves. You know, just by watching them, you're, like, intrigued by it.
Yeah.
With Reigns, it's like... He doesn't have the ring presence to sell me something I already know.
Yeah.
So because of that, he's off.
I think it's the ring pride. I think it's more just his demeanor,
yeah,
personality.
Exactly.
He pretends like nothing.
He either overacts or way underacts.
Yeah, yeah.
So it's like, well, you know, it's also an acting job.
Yeah.
You can't just.
Yeah.
It doesn't work.
Yeah.
So anyway, let's go into a demo. So
yeah, I actually had Roman Reigns like at number 10. I struggled like with number 9 and 10. I had Reigns there for a bit, and I changed them last second. Number 5, I have AJ Styles. Basically what you said, ever since he came in from the Royal Rumble last year, right?
Mm-hmm.
He's been phenomenal. Every match I watch with this guy, it's never disappointing. And I think we all agree that he's the number one wrestler in WWE, like David said. Number 4, Finn Balor. Even though we
the
haven't
Demon
seen,
King.
Yeah, even though we haven't seen much of him, I fell in love with him and his character. I just hope they don't overdo it with his demon.
I don't think so.
I hope that doesn't go stale. Maybe we spoke about this. He should just use it on
paper
special.
Yeah, that's what he did when he was in NXT.
Yeah,
yeah.
But like you never know with the WWE. Number 3, Chris Jericho.
Mm-hmm.
He was my number 1 a few months ago, but I love this guy. Like he's been my favorite. I remember choosing this guy, playing with him on SmackDown vs. Raw. He was like my number 1 guy all the time. I've loved this guy for years. And I think what he's done with Kevin Owens was amazing. It was hilarious.
It's one of the greatest runs in the
yeah.
history of WWE.
Yeah, one of the greatest stories in America.
Yeah.
He even said it. Everyone says this. It's some of his best work of his
yeah.
career. Yeah, I think
100%
he admitted that. And speaking of Kevin Owens, he's my number 2. Ever since coming in, I've even another guy from Quebec.
Yeah.
He's amazing in the ring. He's hilarious. He gets it. He knows how to be a true heel. He knows how to piss off the crowd. Even though the crowd loves it, he does such a good job at it. And my list just disappeared.
I probably deleted it.
Number 1,
I had
Seth Rollins. I've been obsessed with this guy ever since he first came into ever since he was with the Shield. This guy was his athleticism in the ring.
Charisma and athleticism.
He has everything. I agree. I prefer him as a heel too.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm okay with the way he is right now, and ever since he won the title, ever since he won the title too, when he cashed in, I think that caught everyone by surprise,
yeah. And
that's what made me fall in love with him.
Yeah, that was probably the
talking about 31 WrestleMania.
Yeah, WrestleMania 31.
That
yeah.
was a moment where WWE was at a peak of sorts. Like that was a great. Like,
I find that was the breakout.
Yeah,
that was
the launch of the new era.
Exactly.
That was
the unofficial launch of the new era.
We're moving on from Pretty Boy,
yeah,
and you're gonna carry this,
yeah.
And then until he got injured, he did carry it, and
yeah.
then now it's basically Styles and Jericho carrying it.
Yeah.
Okay, both good top fives. Mine, I'll begin with 5. It's Becky Lynch. She's the first ever SmackDown Women's Champion, like you said earlier. There's just something about her personality. She just connects to a crowd,
yeah.
Not in a Cena / Bayley way where they, you know. They're just like you,
yeah.
And it's like everybody.
They're not, she's not the rated everyone. She's the rated T for teen.
Yeah,
she's.
But little girls can look up to her.
Yeah.
Older guys and older women can look, you know, at her and be like, you know, she's really cool. She's someone that, you know,
they're
I relate to.
Yeah.
Exactly. There's just something about her. She's really pretty. She's great in the ring. She's overall, you know, just she just seems like someone who's passionate about the business. She
yeah.
loves what she does, and it shows in the ring.
And she's related to Marshawn Lynch.
Definitely not, but you know,
maybe
one's Irish, one's you know black, but you know that's about it. Number 4, the Demon King, Finn Balor. I know you don't necessarily agree with that. You had him a little.
I know
higher.
He's great. I just find that he hasn't been used properly.
Yeah, well, look, he's been in WWE on the main roster for what, 2 months,
and
a half.
I had him at number 4 as well.
Oh, you did. Okay.
I think so, yeah.
Look, my reason for him being on the list and so high is like you said, I fell in love with his character. I've always been a fan of him in NXT. The whole Demon King thing, the way, you know, he's a normal guy, regular matches, then pay-per-views, he, like, the other side of him comes out. I like that. It's badass. And he's great in ring, and I think the hype behind him coming back has been fuel for a lot of fans to get excited about this Mania, because since the Rumble, there's been rumors about him coming back.
Yeah.
So I think that's a huge thing, and I can't wait to see what happens next, because him being out and still having this relevance, to me, is more than enough to have him high on a list.
Yeah.
And not to mention, he is great in the ring. That those missile drop kicks that he gives
yeah.
look like they hurt a lot.
Wait, do you prefer him coming back tomorrow or seeing him on the...
Oh, no, I definitely want him back at Raw at this point. I don't want him back at Mania. I think it'd be a cop-out at this point that I'm not at Mania. Mania would be better with him in it, but him long-term would be better Monday Raw.
Yeah,
you know, Monday Raw, so...
Yeah.
Okay, number three. The man, Seth Rollins. He was my favorite up until the top two stole it from him this year.
Yeah.
In my opinion, after Styles, he's the best in the ring, Rollins. He, you know, his babyface switch, I don't love it as much as I like his heel, but I feel like if they keep his face going, because I like what he's saying. It didn't make sense why he was pissed off at Triple H for what he did to Owens if he did it to Rollins in to begin with. But now with the injury and him coming back the last couple weeks at Raw, he's finally explaining, like, with my time off from this current injury and my other injury, I have time to reflect, and I don't like who I became after I met you.
It's
when
like,
he
a, it's
said
like
that,
a redemption tour.
Exactly, because at the beginning it didn't really make sense.
Yeah.
And you could tell they kind of forced it because Balor got hurt. So now it's starting to make sense, and I feel it with Balor coming back, Raw after Mania, you're going to see a lot better Seth Rollins. Heel or face, I'm 100% for him. I love him. Bring back the Phoenix Splash, please. Number two, the GOAT, Y2J. The reason why I don't have a number one is because he... is the older guy. The new guys give it, is being passed on the torch, and I'll get to my number one. But Chris Jericho has reinvented himself for the 100th time in his career, and he's 100% spot on. Every time he does it to perfection. He's the only guy to ever reinvent himself this many times and be this relevant and be this good. His in-ring work is second to none. He's a seasoned veteran. He's great on the mic. He's hilarious. He's serious. He pisses you off, he makes you laugh, all in one shot. Y2J, my number two. My number one, the guy from Montreal, Kevin Owens. Or Maryville, Quebec, wherever you officially want to call him from. He lives here now, so he's up from Montreal. Again, him and Chris Jericho, I was fighting which one to give the number one to, but KO got it because he's the young guy. He's going to be the guy we're going to be watching for the next 10 years.
And he's come the furthest,
Jericho.
I think, in
Exactly. People complain about his Universal title run, and he's like, oh, you know, people say, you know, Jericho always helped him, he doesn't look strong. I find he did, because look at a lot of Triple H's runs, or Kurt Angle's runs, who got inducted.
I was about to say Triple H, he did it cerebrally.
Yeah, but look at Kurt Angle, like, he got inducted last night at the Hall of Fame, right? And people complain about Owen's run and how he got a lot of help. Chris Jericho and Kurt Angle got a lot of help earlier in their careers with a lot of their title wins. Stephanie McMahon interfered a lot in those days. So KO having Y2J, it would have been better. Maybe some of the matches Chris Jericho didn't interfere. Sure, but I'm fine with what
made
they did. It was
television.
Great. And the Festival of Friendship literally made my jaw drop. I was almost in tears when that happened because I didn't expect it. So good job, guys.
Let's make our top 10. Let's do that.
Before we get to our consensus top 10, I'm just going to mention a few honorable mentions why I didn't include some guys. Sorry for Randy Orton. Just like the KO Y2J thing, he's the guy passing the torch on sort of thing. I mean, he's still got a lot left in the tank, more than Chris Jericho. But, you know, Bray Wyatt's the young guy, first time WWE champ. I feel like Orton kind of had to be in the background for that. And good on him for it, because he's done a great job with it. The club, Anderson and Gallows, I feel like they have a lot of potential. They're just not being used properly.
Yeah, Chad Too Bad.
He's like Chad Too Bad and what's his name? Tex Ferguson.
Yes.
From Southpaw Regional Wrestling. I love those guys. When they beat the shit out of Sheamus and Cesaro and gave Sheamus those stitches with the ladder, that's what I want to see in, day out with these guys. So let's hope for more. Lesnar, Goldberg. What Lesnar did for Goldberg and losing in less than a minute and 26 seconds, good on him. Much respect for him. He sees the big picture, and he's a great businessman, clearly, and thank you, Lesnar, for honestly, I never thought a guy like him would do that, especially most wrestlers.
Would agree to it.
Yeah, because most wrestlers say he's very hard to work with.
Small as pride.
So, good on you, and Goldberg, you look great. You coming back, you've been always one of my favorites growing up as a kid, so thank you. Sami Zayn, the Montreal Pride, underutilized, has a lot of potential, hopefully next year's his year. Samoa Joe recently got called up, hopefully they do some better. Charlotte, my issue with her is, like you said, the whole Dana Brooke thing. And I hate the fact that she's a 5-time women's champ or 4-time, whatever it is at this point. Trish Stratus is at 7.
She was in a place where, at that time, she was so dominant and so much better than her surrounding.
Oh, I'm not an issue with that.
They didn't really have a chance, choice.
No, it was like, here's Sasha, here's the belt. Oh, wait, it's a pay-per-view. Give it back to Charlotte.
Yeah.
Like, they should have done it once.
Yeah.
And broke Charlotte's pay-per-view streak. back in the fall, not at Fastlane a month ago.
Yeah.
That made no sense. If they were going to keep it till Mania,
yeah,
or break it back then, when it didn't really matter as much.
That's with the, yeah, the thin roster that they have for the women.
Yeah, exactly. So on Sasha on Raw. Yeah,
so but now they finally have enough players.
Yeah, and then the other two from the women on Raw, Sasha and Bayley. Bayley's run, I'm not fully convinced because she's been losing a lot on Raw. But, you know, she's doing a decent job. Yeah. Sasha, she's great. All three of them, you know, they've done a great job. Enzo and Kaz, I'm getting a little bit annoyed of them. I'm not going to lie. It feels very scripted. Only one or two times I felt like I believed in what they were saying. So them, Braun Strowman, this guy, according to all the other guys, I'm not a wrestler, but he's green as fuck. So a lot of people say they're very surprised how fast he's picked up the business.
Yeah.
And so yeah, but he's done a good job.
He is a lot funner to watch.
I could see him becoming the next Big Show, where he has those moments of complete dominance and badass, and then he has those moments where he's the funny guy and laughing. Not the way Big Show's been the last 2-3 years, where he's flip-flopping back and forth. The real Big Show from back in the old days.
The WCW Big Show.
No, not the giant. The real Big Show, the long hair and the earring.
Yeah, they did a good job with him so far.
And he's done a good job adapting to the company. Mickey James came back recently. She's done great for the women on SmackDown. And then Sheamus and Cesaro, I hated the fact that they're together. I didn't understand it. It felt very forced.
Yeah, it ended up being really cool.
It ended up being great.
They play off each other well.
Exactly. Since
the bar fight.
Exactly. And like you mentioned off camera, Austin Aries, he's only been here for a little bit in the ring because of his injury, but what he's done on commentary and now leading up to Mania has been phenomenal.
He was like building his character through
which is amazing. So that's my honorable mentions. And Roman Reigns, I'll give him, look, I love Reigns as a wrestler. Do I think he needs to be heel? Yes. And why? Because I don't like what he says, especially he said it on Jericho's podcast a couple of days ago that he doesn't feel the need to be heel, and for some reason Jericho agreed with this. And again, I'm not a wrestler, they're in the business, I could be 100% wrong, but this is my perspective. He says he doesn't want to be a heel because he's like, look, just let me be me, and whether you boo or cheer for me, as long as you're having a good time, good for you. But I don't want a good guy, but I see him as a bad guy facing another good guy who I see as the real good guy, who's written as a good guy. I don't want, because Jericho's argument is that if they make him a heel, we're going to cheer him. That's not true. No. We're going to boo him. Maybe eventually we'll cheer him. And that's when the baby face run starts. But you look at Austin and Brett, the double switch they did at WrestleMania.
Like Rollins. How long did he get booed? He went heel and everybody loved that he went heel. It was so cool. He became automatically the coolest kid on the block.
Exactly.
But by doing it, you hated for a week. Then you're loved.
Exactly. So let Rollins, let Reigns, Stone Cold agrees with this.
Yeah.
Let Reigns have a nice heel run.
Yeah.
About 6 months to a year.
Yeah.
See where it goes.
Yeah.
Then bring him back as a big guy.
He's gonna face Undertaker. If he beats Undertaker,
he's gonna get hated forever.
He's like, you have to use this hate.
Yeah.
You can't not now. If he gets buried by Undertaker, then it's like.
But you know why he probably won't? Because rumors already have it that him and Strowman are gonna renew their rivalry again. So Strowman's the heel.
Mm.
Reigns is obviously gonna be the good guy.
Yeah.
And with Cena going away to film movies, Reigns does sell the most T-shirts apparently. So. Look, we're kind of in a sticky predicament, but let's hope one day they just give us 6 months to a year, I think is more than enough.
Yeah.
So that's the honorable mentions. Let's get to our consensus.
Our consensus top 10.
Yeah. All right, our consensus top 10 collectively, we're going to come up with a list.
Yeah.
So I got
a rough idea with what we had said, but now we're going to debate out the wrinkles.
So I got Wyatt as 10.
Mm-hmm.
You have...
I had Randy Orton.
Randy Orton.
I had Charlotte.
Charlotte, okay.
That's 10.
So, do you have Bray on your list at all? Can you remember?
No, I didn't have him on my list.
I think he's a fair 10. You have him at... you have Orton at 10.
Yeah. They're feuding with each other, but I can see why you'd pick Wyatt. He's...
He's the new guy.
This is the year where he really came into...
Yeah.
I would say believability.
Absolutely, yeah.
Because every other time, it was like... I found he didn't have the right opponent.
Yeah.
And with Orton, it doesn't... Like, when you look at the two next to each other, it doesn't seem to make any damn sense.
No.
But, they made it work.
Yeah.
And it works really, really well.
Yeah.
So, for that, I will say, you know
he's
what?
He's the champ, so he should be at least.
He's gone up in my stock, and he's a champion.
Yeah.
Top 10, I would say, rounding out makes sense.
Yeah. Okay, so Bray Wyatt, consensus number 10.
Number 10, yeah.
Alright, so number 9. My number 9 is The New Day.
Mm-hmm.
but none of us really have tag teams on our list, and
no.
We could admit they got stale after they lost the
yeah.
belts. And so, I think you don't have Balor on your list at all.
No.
I have him at 4, you have him at 4, so I think to come somewhere in between. He hasn't been in since last August, but I think, like I said earlier, his hype alone is enough to have him on a list, so I think we should have him at 9.
Yeah, and you guys brought up good points about his mystique is still alive and well, even though he's been, you know, he missed a lot of time.
Yeah.
And, I got an open mind to that,
mm-hmm.
and I think he'll do well. It's just, you know, he hasn't had a moment yet.
Yeah. You haven't bought in yet to him, right?
And he has Sami Zayn syndrome where they gave him the belt and then, ow!
Yeah, exactly, yeah.
Like, Sami Zayn, his debut, oh, my head. You can't do that.
Yeah.
Because they're gonna stop.
Like it was in his control.
Yeah, but no,
can't do that.
There's a way to not get
hurt. Yeah, damn it, Seth.
If you get hurt a lot, if you get hurt more than once, they usually say, like, look, we can't be giving you belts and then you get hurt.
Yeah.
Because then you can't make a movie. I can see why we put him on number 9.
Yeah.
You guys had him higher, I put him a little lower. Just because he hasn't had his moment yet.
Yeah.
But once he gets his moment, I think that he's going to ride the wave far.
Hopefully. And yeah, the whole injury thing, like, he hasn't had any major injuries prior to this recently.
Exactly.
To kind of scare us.
It's unfortunate that it came at this time.
Yeah. Okay, so Balor's our number 9.
Number 9.
Alright, so now we'll go to our 8. And my 8 is Cena.
Mm-hmm.
You guys had him a little bit higher in the list.
Yeah, I had him at 6.
You had him at 6.
We both had him at 6.
So you both had him at 6. So who were your 8?
Mine was Becky Lynch.
Becky and?
Mine was Charlotte.
Charlotte, okay. So you know what? I had Becky higher on my list. He had her at that point. You didn't have her at all.
No.
So I feel like Charlotte should take that 8 spot just because...
Yeah, I agree.
Like, she had a great year. She's probably the best women's wrestler on the roster.
Yeah.
The reason why I didn't have her on my top 10 at all, honestly, is more for her mic skills. What she says, I like. I just don't like how she says
it.
Like
her approach, it's like what I said. It could be
a bunch of
improved,
sounds sarcastic all the time, and she sounds like she's screaming 24/7. I'm sorry, Dana! Like, that's... it's just, there's... Lower your tone a little bit. Sound a little bit more, you know, on everyone else's level.
I'm just waiting for her to pull out the jet-flying, limousine-riding Charlotte Flair.
We'll see.
I hope that happens.
Yeah.
You would have no idea how happy I would be if she just literally copied Ric Flair word for word.
Yeah.
It would be the funniest thing ever.
Okay, so Charlotte, our number 8. I think that's fair.
Yeah, I think so too.
Alright, so let's move on to number 7.
Mm-hmm.
My 7 is Alexa. Who's your 7?
I have Lesnar.
Lesnar?
I actually had Enzo and Cass.
Okay, so going back then to Becky.
Yeah.
I think she deserves that spot at 7.
Mm-hmm.
She, you know, some would say Charlotte had a better year than Becky did, but I think Becky at the beginning had a lot less to work with.
I think he improved a lot more.
Yeah, exactly.
Given what she had worked with, because in SmackDown there was really...
There was a lot more women, but... less experienced women. You had Alexa, who didn't have, you know, any experience on the main roster. Mickie James wasn't in yet. You had Naomi, who was, you know, injuries and coming back, changing her gimmick, flip-flopping a little bit. I find Becky had less to work with at the beginning when she won the first belt, and that's what made it even more special, and that's why I feel she gets number 7, and I think we can all agree that she deserves number 7 on that list. Okay, let's move on to 6. I had Styles. You guys both had Cena.
Yeah, we both had Cena.
I think Cena. Cena for me was number 8, so I think Cena is would be great as a number 6. The guy, like we said, 15 years of consistency. People hate him. I don't really get why.
That consistency keeps him kind of in the middle, where he could be a top guy, or he could be like kind of in the irrelevant matches just to give him some relevance.
And what he did to Miz on Tuesday, where he burned him.
Yeah.
That was a crazy.
Give credit to Miz too, because they took that like a mediocre match
and turned it into.
Like,
yeah,
a lot of people didn't want that, and now they.
I was gonna say an honorable mention. I don't think we have the Miz, but he's been really good.
100%. I don't think I mentioned him actually in my honorable mention, but yeah, Miz. We always talk about it. How he's just that. He's that blue collar, real company
shows
logo guy.
Work,
where you know what, you're gonna wear this stupid hat. He'll do it. You're gonna be WWE champion. Okay, like he earned whatever he got. He earned it. Is he the greatest in ring guy? No.
No.
Does he have the greatest look? No.
But
he makes everything he
has
work.
Work and his segment work.
Yeah.
Is really good.
Because
he's an actor before he's a wrestler.
Yeah.
And it, you know, it's his persona too.
Yeah.
But it's great.
Yeah,
and I find, like you said, with working with Cena, Cena's one of the guys that can work with anybody.
Yeah.
And you put him with Miz when they were doing that Bella interview.
Yeah.
It was so
thing,
funny.
They did a really good job. Congrats to Miz and Cena. You know, let's hope we get, I'd love a 10 more years of Cena. Probably not going to happen, but let's hope for 5 more years of some Cena. All right, so Cena's at 6.
Mm-hmm.
5. I had Becky, so she's already taken up a spot.
I had Brock Lesnar in at 5.
Lesnar?
I have Styles.
Styles, where do you have Lesnar on your list?
Lesnar, I'm 7.
Okay, I don't have Lesnar at all on my list, but going back to what we said earlier about Goldberg and the honorable mentions, where, you know, much respect for him for swallowing his pride and basically looking like an idiot at the Rumble and at the Survivor Series. And last week on Raw, where again, one spear, that's all it took again to pick him up. Exactly. So good on you, Lesnar, and I feel like he deserves a spot.
Mm-hmm.
He's probably going to be Universal Champion come Sunday night.
Yeah.
And I'm not even mad at it anymore. I was kind of pissed when he was WWE Champion. I'm not pissed anymore that he's Universal Champion because I bought into what he is.
Yeah.
I bought into that prize fighter. I do whatever I want to do, how I want
to
do it.
He has to.
Exactly. I bought into it. So I think Lesnar at a 5 is extremely fair.
Yeah.
He had a great year. You know, 3 years ago, he broke the streak. I mean, that alone solidified what would be a 3-year dominant reign that Goldberg would squash in a minute, 26 seconds.
Yeah.
But again, going back to the real life, he said okay to it. He didn't have to.
Yeah.
He did it because I'm pretty sure Vince would have went with whatever Lesnar said over with whatever Goldberg wanted to do. So good on Lesnar. Let's hope they Lesnar-Goldberg erases WrestleMania 20 from existence, because that was a bad match, mostly because of the fans booing them. The match itself wasn't terrible, but you could tell they weren't 100% in it. So Lesnar at 5. Move on to 4. I had 4. I had Finn. We already had Finn at 9. Who do you have at 4?
I had Finn as well.
And?
I had Goldberg at number 4.
Goldberg? Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So we have...
Although that was kind of a nostalgia pick.
Yeah. Okay, so who we have left is basically KO, Rollins, Y2J... and AJ Styles. And I think we could agree that AJ Styles having that crazy run in the fall and basically being the best technical wrestler in the WWE right now and being great on the mic as well and selling a lot of shirts to kids and crazy style that he has, no pun intended. And the fact that no one ever thought he'd be in WWE, let alone a WWE champion. So I think that alone makes him deserving of a 4th spot.
He's another consistently good guy.
Yeah.
But the benefit he has over Cena is that everything's new right now.
Yeah. Yeah.
So it's really fun to watch.
Yeah. Because where do you have Styles on your list?
I had him at number 3.
You had him at 3 and you had him at?
I had him at number 5.
Yeah. And I had him at 6. So, somewhere right in the middle.
Fair,
yeah. So 4 is a good spot for him. And I feel like, again, he deserves it.
Yeah.
I'm really happy he's here. And let's hope for he puts on a good show against Shane, because it's kind of could be lackluster. I think Shane's gonna have that one high spot to kind of save it, but I think I think it's kind of wasting a match on Styles. You know, the guy is kind of old.
If anyone's gonna make that match good, it's gonna be Styles.
Yeah. All right. So Styles at 4, 3 next. So my number 3 was Seth.
I had Styles, but Seth's a really good wrestler.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah. And you have.
I had Jericho, but like my top 3, like I really don't care. Like it can go either way.
But Seth's your number 1, right?
Seth's he's my number 1.
And you had Seth at.
I had him lower down the.
You had him
like 7 or 8.
Seven,
okay, so 3 is almost. It's exactly where I had him. It's kind of in the middle because, I mean, this guy, if he didn't have all of these injuries, who knows how different the things would have went.
Yeah.
He constantly puts on great matches. He's a great.
He killed Sting.
He literally killed Sting and he killed Balor.
Yeah.
Did the same move.
Yeah.
So, yeah, Rollins I think deserves a number 3.
Yeah. That's self evident. He's just so good.
Yeah. He's the man.
Overall, yeah.
He's the man.
His physique.
Seth
freaking
Rollins.
His style.
His
actual merchandise style. His pants are so cool all the time.
Yeah. That Target logo that he has there.
He's got the best merch and
his music is just great.
Yeah. And he's funny on commentary. He's funny in the ring.
His belt celebrations.
Yeah. He's just a real genuine guy.
Yeah. A lot of stuff he does is great. All right.
Tyler Black.
So Tyler Black, exactly. All right. Number 2. I have Y2J, Chris Jericho. You have
I had Jericho as my number 1 and KO as my number 2. But after debate, I can see how we can say that Jericho, while he's at his best right now, I think, in a long time at least, he is passing the torch to
KO.
KO.
Yeah.
And KO is a guy Triple H built up in NXT, and he's, he's given him all the opportunities possible now, and he's cashed in on every single one.
Yeah.
So because of that, I think a nice 2-1 combo is Jericho number two, but I think the best wrestler we can all agree is Kevin Owens.
Yeah,
Kevin Owens.
He has had a year that few people can say they've had.
Mm-hmm.
He's had a great run with a great partner, and I just can't even imagine after more experience and more time what this guy's going to do.
But think about this, Kevin Owens definitely does not have the physique.
No.
English is his second language.
Yeah.
And he made everything work.
Yeah.
And say what you want about the Universal title, how ugly it is, and maybe some people still don't see it as legit as the WWE belt, he still made it pretty legit.
Yeah.
I believe it's the second biggest belt in WWE, if not the biggest, tied with WWE.
Yeah.
So there you go. KO number one, Y2J number two, Seth Rollins number three, AJ Styles number four, Brock Lesnar number five, John Cena number six, seven Becky, eight Charlotte, nine Balor, 10 Wyatt. So that's it, guys.
And you know, we look at this, and a couple of years ago, WWE was struggling so hard.
Yeah,
the storylines were so terrible.
Yeah.
And they've really done a good turnaround in the last 4 years.
Yeah.
To just really be able to roll with the punches. If people leave, they have enough talent that, you know what, we're okay. And their pipeline is full. They have the cruiserweight division that we didn't even touch.
No, we didn't touch at all.
Which
I think there's a lot of potential behind it if it's booked properly.
Yeah,
another guy didn't mention at all, Neville.
Yeah, Neville.
You know, the King Neville thing, I'm really buying into that a lot.
Yeah. He was lost, and I actually said he needs a place where he can be dominant, but he can't be dominant in the big picture. They put him in the cruiserweight division, and it's the perfect division for him. Acrobatic wrestling.
Yeah.
Very cool.
And she doesn't even do much acrobatics now as a heel anyway, it makes it even better.
It's beautiful. So I think there's a bright future ahead for WWE, and we'll keep talking about it throughout this the high life of this channel.
Yeah. All right, guys. So that's the top 10.
Yeah.
Hopefully, it'll get better. We'll do one next year for next year's WrestleMania. Hopefully, we'll have something else planned. We're not doing any predictions this year for WrestleMania just because last year's WrestleMania was such a disappointment that we didn't even want to do the recap at the end. And it was just, we don't want to have that. Maybe next year we'll do it. We'll see how it goes. But we are starting WrestleMania 3 writing.
Yep.
We've got some ideas brewing in the old noggin, which here, I'll let you hold this belt. You could
grab
your belt. I'm the actual champion currently in our
storyline.
We'll see how it goes. I don't think I'm going to lose it this summer. We'll see what happens because I'm not going to let him take it away from me that easily.
I paid for this belt.
I didn't pay for this one because I got it as a gift, I remember, for like Christmas when I was like 12 or something. We'll see what happens, guys, with WrestleMania 33, April 2nd. Probably release it the day, this video the day of WrestleMania before the actual show starts. Mm-hmm. I have to be editing all night. But we'll see how it goes. Thank you so much for watching, guys. We really appreciate it. Subscribe if you haven't. Like the video. Share it with your friends. And comment down below your favorite wrestlers of the last year.
Give us your old list and we'll rip them off later.
Exactly. And we'll steal that the way we stole the name of this show and the way we stole a lot of stuff that we do. Because we don't give a fuck. So, thank you so much for watching, guys. Stay tuned for more. And we will see you next time. Take care, guys.